Hey guys, Christi here from DPC Technology, and today I want to talk to you guys about Microsoft CoPilot. Now there's a big buzz out there right now because it's finally become available to non-enterprise users. It used to be limited to businesses with over 300 employees, and recently they've released it where you can purchase it if you are a smaller business. So we went ahead and purchased a copy, and we've been playing around with it, so I want to show you some of the things that we found are pretty cool. But to start with, I want to kind of explain all the different versions, because you may actually have a version on your computer that's the free version. So as you can see on my screen here, there is the free version, and then there's CoPilot Pro, which is $20, and that you can use for individuals. So you don't have to have a business account in order to use CoPilot Pro, and that is $20 a month. CoPilot for Microsoft 365, which is the one that you would want to use for business users, is $30 a month, which isn't too bad, except that it's an annual commitment. So you're going to have to go ahead and buy that 1 year subscription to use it. We think that annual subscription is worth it, especially because if you use all your productivity apps like Word, Excel, PowerPoint, it integrates with those apps, whereas the free version doesn't. And that's really where the power of CoPilot comes into play. And I'll show you some examples here and you can make up your mind on your own. So the free version has the chat option, which is very similar to what you've seen already in ChatGPT, but you can pull it up right on your desktop. So if you're working and you have a question, instead of maybe Googling it, you could go over to the chat and type in your question there, and it's using AI to answer your question. But like I mentioned before, I think the real power in this is in the app. So you can get that in the individual subscription, which is called CoPilot Pro, which is the $20 a month if you're just using it for personal use. But for work, it's $30 a month for that annual subscription. The difference in the CoPilot for Microsoft 365 version is not only does it work in those apps like Microsoft Outlook, Excel, PowerPoint, and OneNote, but it also works in Microsoft Teams. So that's pretty cool. And I have a feeling there's gonna be some really interesting stuff coming down the pipe for that. But I'll show you right now kind of some of the things that I've been using that I think are pretty cool. Okay, so now I'm showing you what we can do in Word. Once again, this is pretty similar to ChatGPT, but it's right in your Word document. So you don't have to go out, copy and paste. You can go right in here. So as you see, right when I open a new document, because I have the CoPilot plugin, it just pops up, do you want to draft with CoPilot? So you can say in here, write me a letter to clients about our holiday hours. We are going to be closed for the 4th of July. And then I'll say generate. And as you can see, I misspelled things in there and I don't think it cares, which if you've noticed, ChatGPT doesn't care either, which is awesome. Holiday hours notice to your valued clients. It's great. So we're gonna open on July 5th. If you have any questions or concerns. Now you can say keep it, or you can say make this more formal. It takes a few seconds to generate, which is kind of what I'm seeing when I use ChatGPT. Actually, I've always used the free version of ChatGPT, so it may have taken a little longer. It may be similar to what you see for the paid version of ChatGPT. But here's the new, more formal letter. And so you can say, I want to keep it. So let's say we want to keep it. And then you can come in here and edit stuff, which, you know, I'd always recommend going and editing things to make sure it doesn't sound too ChatGPT or, you know, obvious that you're using AI to write the letter, but still pretty cool. This is a pretty basic example, but there's more things you can do. I also want to mention when I first got CoPilot, I was confused because as I see this icon up here on the right, top right-hand corner, and I would go in here and type things and nothing would really happen. I didn't realize that when you're typing in your document, there's a little icon here that actually does what we were doing before and pulls up that pop-up. So it's a little tricky if you don't know that that's there, you're looking over here and trying to figure things out. So I would recommend using this little icon. Like I said, I think they're still working on it and it's gonna get better and better. So from what I understand, this button over here is actually just launching the chat. So you can ask a question about this document and it will give you an answer. But this little icon over here is actually working inside the document. So that's why it pulls it up and says, let's draft a document or reference a file and that kind of stuff. So that's the difference that I'm seeing. So at DPC, we have a quarterly contest. It's usually around health or fitness or something. So last quarter it was around physical activity intensity minutes. And we have a document here that kind of shows what are the parameters of the contest. Clicked on the Copilot chat icon and then asked it to summarize this document. And then it just gave kind of top three bullet points of what's the purpose, the definition of intensity minutes, and the prizes for each tier. So pretty cool how it can just read through and summarize a document. So this is very helpful if you have a very long document that you have to read through, but you just want to see the highlighted bullet points. So it just gives you a quick bullet point. You don't have to read through everything. It's very helpful. You guys have probably seen Clay's video about Excel Formula Bot, which is great, but it's another expense, it's another app. This is all built right into Excel. So I'm very excited to see all the different things that we can do in here and formulas it can help me with. One of the things I didn't understand, although it prompts you, but I wasn't paying attention, is that you have to have your data in a table. You can use the chat feature as it is, but in order for it to analyze your data or add columns or rows, it needs to be in a table format. If I highlight this data and I just go to format as a table, and you can pick whichever one, I always pick the first one, click okay, it's now in a table. So now that I'm in here and I got the Copilot chat over here, I'm gonna pull it up. So over here I could say, tell me who made the most salary. Analyzing the data. And you can see here that Jennifer Jones has the highest salary, which is correct. All right, so I'm gonna say total column D. Some of these, it's probably faster to just do the summary yourself. But when you have a lot of data, it makes sense to do something like that. Now I'm gonna see if it'll do add a row with the average salary. It doesn't seem to like that. It says, I'm sorry that it cannot be done right now. So you could say highlight the highest values in the salary. So it gives you some cool stuff. Like let's try that just by clicking on the prompt. So I just put a green highlight over Jennifer Jones, which is pretty cool. So since it wouldn't do the average salary for me, I'm just gonna ask it to tell me what the, give me the formula to calculate the average salary. And then it gives it to me. You can use average function to calculate average salary, average range. So it does give it to you. You could also say sort, which, you know, once again, some of the stuff, if it's pretty easy to sort yourself, but it's cool to see that it can do that for you. And if you have a lot of data, you know, a lot of these things might make sense. Okay, now I'm gonna ask it to give me, since it didn't give me the average before, let me see if I can ask it a different way and ask it for the specific cells and the average and see if it will do it then. So let's say, give me the formula for the average of cell D2 through D7. This is kind of a simple version of what we use Excel Formula Bot for. We'll see how it does it here in Copilot. You can use the average function to calculate average D through to the average would be average D2 to give you the average. So in this case, what's cool about it is you can just copy and paste this formula and put it here, and there you have your average. Obviously, it would be nice if that was just something it automatically did, like it did the total and all these other cool things, but I have a feeling that's coming, and at least there's a kind of a workaround where it will give you the formula and you can copy and paste it. Just like I said, we kind of use Excel Formula Bot for now. Okay, let's try a complicated formula. Let's ask it, how many days has Elizabeth been alive? So it didn't actually calculate it for us, but it told us that we could calculate it by subtracting her birth date from today's date. I'm just gonna say, can you give me the formula to calculate this? Okay, so here it says you can use the date diff function to calculate the number of days between two dates. It's pretty cool. I've never even heard of that function before, so I can copy that. Just so you know, when I right click, it doesn't give me the option, but if I control C, it does copy it. So I copied and pasted it. I did have to tell it that C was where birth date was, but after that, it calculated that for me. So that is pretty cool. Well, that was way faster than how long it would have taken me to go to Google and get that solution. So I would say for some complicated functions, it's pretty cool. You do have to work with it a little bit. It didn't just automatically do that. So you do have to, you know, kind of play with it a little bit, but super fast. Even with all the manipulating there, it was faster than what I've done in the past. All right, let's go over some cool features in Outlook using CoPilot next. The first thing is obviously similar to what there was in Word, you can have it draft an email for you. So I can just go right here and click Draft with CoPilot. And then that pops up this window and I can say, let my client know they have a past due invoice of $100, and then click generate. I hope this email finds you well. I am writing to inform you there's a past due invoice of $100 on your account. To avoid any finance charges, you can call us to make a payment at your earliest convenience. We appreciate your prompt attention to this matter. Thank you for your business. So I could keep that, or I could regenerate if I didn't like that. So I might just say, well, let's do another. I'm writing to inform you that you have a past due invoice of $100. Please call us to make payment to avoid finance charges. We value your business and want you to ensure your account stays in good standing. Thank you for your prompt attention. So I like that one better. So I'm gonna say, keep it. There is an option in here that's called Coaching by CoPilot, which I've played around a little bit. Essentially, you could write an email and then have the coach kind of give you recommendations. If you want to do that, that's fine. Or maybe you started an email and you went, oh man, yeah, let me see what CoPilot thinks about it. Then you could have coaching review it. But a lot of times I would just say draft with it. Okay, so I've got this email from Adrian. He sent me a cool PDF. I can also summarize the email up here. You see there's a summary by CoPilot button. It's not a very long email, but we'll click it and see what it says. Adrian has provided information about their company's different email addresses for support. So it's really reading his signature there and giving me a summary of his signature, which is a little silly, but I guess that's because there's not a lot of content in this email. But if I wanted to go reply, I can say down here, you'll see where CoPilot will say, need more details, sorry, wrong recipient, or whatever you want to say here. Thank you, send handout. So there's like quick responses that you could say, and you could also just draft an email here. So it just gives you quick little shortcuts for responding to emails. I find that the real power here is not so much in Outlook, but in the Teams integration with Outlook. So let me pop over to that and show you some cool things in there. So one of my biggest pet peeves about Outlook is the search sometimes is not what you like. And I found that using CoPilot in Teams, you can kind of work around that. So I know that Clay sent me an email about our continuing education credits, but I couldn't find it today. It's hard for me to see. I got so many emails. So I'm gonna ask search my email for one from Clay about CE. It's coming through my emails. And here it is. I found an email from Claire, which was sent yesterday afternoon. Ticket reminder of expiration date. Your CE broker tracking number, blah, blah, blah. Pretty freaking cool, I think that is, because I am always trying to weed through my emails. And even from here, I can say reply to Clay Archer. See what that does. Okay, so it's then actually replying to Clay. It looks like it's looking to see if I replied to Clay. But I think that's pretty cool. Sometimes when I'm looking, you can see I use it a lot. I'm trying to find a receipt or something that is just buried in my email somewhere. I probably moved it to some other folder and I can't find it. So this search actually helps a lot for that. Okay, so I'm gonna ask it to summarize my emails from Sherry today. I know I get a lot of emails from Sherry throughout the day, and let's see what it does. So you can see all the emails that I got from Sherry. It's finding them, telling me when I received them, and what was the topic of the email. So if I click into this number 2, that's pretty cool. I can ask it to search and then I can click and it opens it in the web browser. So it's not my desktop app, but that's still pretty cool that I can have it bring me over to the email so then I could reply or whatever. The other thing I wanted to show, but I wasn't able to, but I want to explain to you why, is you can have Teams help you summarize your meeting. So if you have a meeting with a group of people, which we often have, and there's some bullet points, there's some to-dos, you can actually have it listen to the meeting and record the meeting and then give you a transcription of a summary or to-dos, all of that stuff through Teams. What I found, the reason I couldn't show you today, is you have to record the meeting and you have to have transcription turned on, and ours was not turned on, and it takes a while once you turn it on for it to actually start working. So I've tried that. Maybe we'll do another video later showing you how that transcription works with videos within your meetings, but I think that would be a very valuable tool going forward, where you can just have CoPilot record your meeting, transcribe everything, and give you a summary and a list of to-dos for each person. So that's pretty powerful. I'm looking forward to that, seeing how that works. Those are some of the top tips and tricks that I've been using. I'd love to hear what you guys are doing. If you can put that in the comments below, or anything that you'd like to see in the future from Microsoft. I'm sure we all have a lot of things that we can see the power in this tool, and I'd love to see what you guys think down in the comments below. Also, please like this video, subscribe to our channel, and we'll see you in the next video.